guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. Today I have a Sprouts haul for you guys, and I actually got a lot of stuff this time, and I did pretty good, I feel like, on prices. Right now, I wanted to throw this out there. Through Wednesday, they are having a great sale right now on most plant-based items, 35% off. And then if you spend like over $25, you get an additional $5 off, which is pretty cool. So there's still time to get down to your Sprouts if you need to pick up some of these items as well. But I thought I would definitely share them with you guys. I will put the prices with everything. Got a few new items this time too. And then of course some tried and trues, and then stuff that I've had before, but not in a very long time. So I thought it was a good mix this time and definitely wanted to share it. So I hope you guys enjoy. Please do give it a thumbs up. I appreciate it. And let's just get into this haul, and I will see you guys soon. Okay, so first items I picked up were these organic by Sprouts baby spinach and their 50-50 blend of baby lettuces. It's basically just literally like baby lettuce and baby spinach in here. I really do like it. Got two huge tubs of this. I do have some spinach left, but I'm gonna use majority of what I do have left to make another big batch of soup. I've shared this soup recipe now many times, and Nate is still hooked, so a lot of the stuff you'll see is to make more soup. We make it like every week now. He loves it. Anyway, so got some of that, also for salads, of course. And I went back. This is one of those items that I have not had in a very, very long time, but used to get often, is the Silver Hills bread, the squirrely bread. I used to get this so much, and it's so, so good. Lately, we've been buying the Ezekiel bread, but this was actually on sale, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna go back to this. It's very similar. It is a sprouted bread. It is definitely lower carb than most, and I think it's delicious. It's so good. And sometimes we just like to change it up and not have oats. Well, I mean, I do, but you guys know the drill. I love my oatmeal, but Nate sometimes likes his bread. I get it, and I'll have some sometimes as well. So anyway, these were on sale, and I got the sprouted power one and then the squirrely bread. This one's called the Big 16. It has like 16 different seeds and grains in it. I think I've had this one before. Again, it's just been a long time, so I got those. They are vegan friendly, very, very good. These are not gluten-free breads though, just to throw that out there if you eat gluten-free. Sometimes it can be a little deceiving of like you think that because it's sprouted, oh, it's gluten-free. No, it doesn't mean that. Anyway, I also picked up this little thing of Sprouts. It's kind of funny that like for whatever reason, Sprouts can be really tough to find. I don't know why that is. Like Trader Joe's even, they don't carry Sprouts at all. And they're really, really good, especially like in a wrap instead of doing like lettuce. It's just a nice little change up. So I got this for that in mind. And then I also picked up, you know the drill, my blueberries. I got two cases of these. These were on sale as well right when you walked in. And I do still have a little bit left, but I go through about a cup a day minimum. So they get eaten. They've never gone to waste here. And I also picked up two little things of raspberries. These were also on sale for like 2 for $3, I think it was. And I haven't had raspberries in a while, so I went ahead and got some of those. Now I mentioned I was gonna make the soup again, but also I'm going to make the lasagna mac that I actually shared with you guys in a recipe video just a week ago. I'll put it right up here for you guys if you have missed that, but I'm gonna make that again too. That's what also what Nate wanted prepped this week. These are both the soup and that lasagna mac is a great prepped meal. So definitely do that. If you've not tried that before, you'll love it. So good. Anyway, I needed more of this Banza pasta to do that. So I got the elbow one. And if you're not familiar with Banza, it is made with chickpeas and it has tons of protein in it. And I really like it. Now, I will say this is kind of a mixed item. A lot of people do or don't like it. I love it. Nate really isn't a big fan of it, but he does like it in that recipe I was talking about. So he was like, if there's other options though, I'm open to that still, but he does like it in that. And it's kind of tough. If you're looking for a pasta, you know, of course, use whatever pasta you do want, but if you're looking for one specifically, like I was trying to, you know, do in that video of that recipe, is something that's very high protein, this is kind of the best solution I have found so far for that in mind. Anyway, so I got the elbow one. And then the penne one as well. Again, I really like them though. I think they're good. And then in that soup too, I got this a couple weeks ago when I did go to Sprouts, and I got this farro with the porcini mushroom, like kind of spice blend in it. honestly, you guys know I'm not a mushroom person. This was delicious. It was really, really good in the soup. So I went ahead and bought two of these just to have on hand. I'll add a full one for the whole batch of soup. Farro is so good, guys, in soups, like a veggie soup. Amazing. It's just a great little add of carbs and a little add of protein. And it can really fill you up. Whereas a veggie soup on its own, they're good, but they don't really stick with you. This makes it stick and it's awesome. And farro is kind of like a brown rice is how I would describe it in texture. Very, very yummy. Anyway, so got two of those. Love that. Never had this brand until recently. And we really, really like that. And then I went ahead and picked up this Sweet Earth Chipotle style seitan. And I don't believe I have tried the Chipotle style one before. And this is already made into strips and it's 25 grams of protein per serving, which is awesome. I actually showed my last what I ate in a day, which I can put up here for you as well. I showed some seitan that I was eating as well. And this is something that is a great source of protein as a quick fix for protein even because it's just so loaded with it. And you can even eat it like on its own. It's good. But I wanted to try the Chipotle style one this time. And again, guys, all of this stuff, or at least most of it, not every single like plant-based brand was part of their sale, but most of it was, where you got like 35% off the original pricing. And then again, $5 off if you spend a certain amount. I also went ahead and picked up some of these, you know the drill, the crispy onions, garlic pepper ones, our favorite. We actually don't really need these right now. But you know, I say that because we have a couple bags, but that will go in a few days. we're not that bad. But anyway, I figured since they were there and I was there, I would just grab a couple more. Basically, we always pick these up if we see them. Now, I also went ahead and got a bundle here of asparagus. Looks pretty good. And actually, on my last vlog from yesterday, I gave you guys kind of a life update of some changes going to be happening. And one of those is adding a person to the family. And she keeps telling us, she's like, I see you guys make asparagus and I really want to try yours because I don't really know the best way to make it. It's not been something that she's really played with too much. And so we're going to make her asparagus this week. So that was the thought with that. We love it. It's a go-to for us anyway. So got some of that. And then I also got two purple onions. I do still have some shallots left for that soup to make a new batch. And if you don't have shallots though, just use any kind of onion, but I'll use this for other things throughout the week, of course. And then guys, I don't know what it is lately, but normally I am the one that buys like the smaller avocados, more of like can even be like a single serving size even. But lately I have been going to these ginormous ones and I don't know why. I'm just like, I want a big avocado. Now I don't usually eat the whole thing at once, but I eat half and that's still a good amount. But these just looked really, really good to me. They need a little more time to ripen up, but they're almost there and I'm excited. So I got those as well. And then a batch here of bananas. That's the rest of our fruit for the week, by the way. I mean, it was pretty low. So I definitely needed to stock up on some of that. And then I bought this a couple weeks ago at Sprouts too, just to try out because I had like a coupon for it. These Zevia zero calorie energy little energy drinks. These are good, you guys. They're really good. I'm really impressed with the Zevia brand overall. Even their like fake out sodas, they're so good. The sodas can be a little pricey, but they are good. I love them. Now you would have to be a stevia person. Now some people are and aren't. So if you're not, you probably won't like them, but I personally do like stevia a lot. So these are good. These are the raspberry lime ones. So I just got two more of those because they were on sale too. And then I have not purchased kombucha in a while. We got on a kick there for a while and kind of got away from it. Nate still picked them up here and there for himself, but I haven't had it in a while. And this was my very first brand I ever tried, was the Health Aid one. And I really, really liked it. I will tell you, if you've never had it before though, ever had a kombucha, be careful. Like, don't have too much. Can kind of be a little too much on the stomach sometimes. And it's a probiotic. And yeah, just kind of, you know, ease into the kombucha world. But I wanted to get them again. They were on sale as well. And this maca berry one is delicious. So I got that one. And then the pink lady apple. I think this is still sold at Trader Joe's as well. This flavor, very, very good. So I got two of those. And then I got two lemons here just for waters and also for the asparagus. And then I picked up another one of these little Nun energy like tablet drink, or you add them to your drink. They're little tablets. And this one is the energy one, so it does have some added caffeine. They do have some that aren't added caffeine, but more of just the electrolytes and extra hydration and that kind of thing. But I have a little variety of these now. I really like these. They're really good. And I've been taking this sometimes before I work out. And you know what? It gets me sweating. It does. I kind of wondered, like, how much is it really going to do? I drink coffee as is, but maybe the combo of both, it works for me. So I wanted to get another one of these as I only have one left. And then over here, I went ahead and picked up the Gardein Beefless Grounds. Now, I had mentioned to you guys for the beginning of the year that, like, I'm going to try to kind of not, you know, rely on these as much. Just one for price. These have really shot up recently in price, which, you know, is cool that they're becoming so popular and everything, but obviously we want the price to stay low. But we've been kind of just going the tofu route where it works and you can marinate that to be whatever you want it to be and it's cheaper. But I wanted again to go ahead and make that lasagna mac, and when in the recipe I did it with the Beyond Meat burgers, and because this is a little cheaper than doing it that way, I went this route this time for that reason. But anyway, these are really good. If you've never had them before, great for making tacos, great for making like a spaghetti meat sauce. It's awesome. Love the grounds. They're really good. The Trader Joe's ones are delicious too. Honestly, almost any of the meatless grounds I've actually been a fan of. I can't think of any off the top of my head that like I haven't liked. So they're really good. I recommend. Now this I've never tried before, but again, they were on sale and I was like, I just want to try it just to, you know, have another brand out there I can speak to. But I was like, what is that brand? And then it says right there, only what you need is the, what it like stands for. I'm like, that's kind of cute. So anyway, this is a plant-based protein drink. And basically, you know, we buy the protein powders all the time. We make protein shakes often, but this one's already ready to go out the door, which is kind of nice too, of course. But overall, the powders are definitely more cost effective. But again, this was on sale and I just wanted to try it. And I did go ahead and get the dark chocolate flavor and then the cold brew coffee flavor. They sound delicious. But they're 20 grams of protein, 180 calories per bottle, and 11 carbs, 5 from fiber, 7 fat. That's pretty standard, really, to most of the protein powders that I have seen. So, I mean, as far as like that part goes, it seems to be right up there with everything else, but we'll see how the taste is. Anyway, I also got this puree Roma tomatoes, no salt added. It's a big can, and I do put this into the soup. I've been using two smaller cans, but they have this bigger one, so I just went ahead and did that this time. Now, last haul, I mentioned to you guys that I wasn't sure what to do with the whole milk situation. So, we love flax milk. We really do, but it's pricey. It really is. The flax milk with added protein in it, it's pricey. And we went ahead and did soy milk, and the macros and everything on it are very, very similar to flax milk, but it is cheaper. And a lot of you agreed that like really go the soy route. But an option I could do to get flax in, because I do think flax is really like a great like thing to have into your diet, is to go ahead, and I used to do this and I totally forgot about it, but add flax meal, that's what this is, ground up flax, into like my oatmeal. Just do like a tablespoon and you got your flax for the day, you know? So I went ahead and in their bulk bins got a thing of flax meal, and I'll just transfer this into like a glass jar. And yeah, so I'm gonna do that, and I think we're gonna stick with the soy milk for a while. And I even picked up more today, and I will show you which one in just a minute, and we're loving it. Anyway, you guys are gonna laugh. So there's a story. I saw this there. You guys know I love my peanut butter. That's become a thing. But so I see that they have this calorie free by Walden Farms, which is known for being like calorie free. And let's just be honest, it's just a bunch of crap. It is what it is, but it's calorie free. I mean, let's see here. I've tried some of their things and I have not been a fan. That's the truth. So when this goes to complete garbage and I have a backup here. Anyway, have any of you tried this at all? What are your thoughts? Should I just throw it away now? Not even try? Guys, truly, I just want to try it. That's really what it is. Should we try it? Let's try it. Let's do it.
All right, we're gonna give it a little taste test. It looks terrible. It's watery. It's not. I'm a little nervous. It doesn't smell great. Look, I appreciate what the brand's doing, but no. No. Oh my God. Garbage.
So like I said, when that goes into the garbage, like it did, that's terrible, guys. I went ahead and got my backup. I've never tried this one before, but pretty much I do like any real peanut butter. So this is by Home Plate, the creamy peanut butter here. And it still has the like sugar and palm oil and stuff in it, which is fine. I'm not like crazy about that, but I personally do just love just peanuts and salt. It's delicious. They just didn't really have that there with a adequate price. So I'll have to stock up on that at Costco the next time I'm there, or Trader Joe's again, which is more normally where I get it. But I'll try this out. I'm sure it's very good, and I get the creamy one. I usually buy rice cakes like often, and I usually get this brand. We really like them. They're very good, but I always just get the sea salt ones, I think it is, and just kind of the plain ones. My kiddo loves that. And I was like, you know, I want to have, like, when you get that little sweet craving, this can do it, and put real peanut butter on it. But I went ahead and got the cinnamon toast organic rice cakes, and then the caramel corn. Both are vegan. Sometimes you have to be careful. Like, most of the time rice cakes, you're always going to be good and they're going to be vegan. But sometimes with certain flavored ones, always double check depending on the brand and stuff. But these are, so I'm excited to try those. I've never had them before, or if I have, it's been a very long time. Another thing I picked up as a snack, supposed to be a little bit better, but when you get that munchy feeling, I went ahead and got some of these Harvest snap peas. Now, I have had these before, but again, not in a very long time, but these were on sale as well. One of these, though, is the red lentil ones. It's a tomato basil flavor, and then these are the green pea ones here, and there's black pepper, and then just the original lightly salted ones. They're pretty good. I have had them, again, like I said, a long time ago, and they're really good just for that kind of chip craving too. You guys know my problem with chips. I also went ahead and got some more of these oranges. These were on sale for a good price, so I got some more of those. And then, guys, they had this on sale because of the whole plant-based like sale they were doing. This is so good, you guys. I highly recommend it. This is the light version of the So Delicious Cocoa Whip, but even the original too, which is hardly different in macros. I just didn't see it there this time, is just as good too. Either one. Love this, and I'll be honest, I store it in my freezer, and it's almost like ice cream to me versus like a Cool Whip, and I'll just literally come and get like a scoop of it at night when I just have that little sweet craving. But it's also good like on your coffee. It's yummy. It's a good treat. Now, this here was also on sale, and I've never tried this one before, and I'm really hoping that I really like it because the macros are pretty good on this. But I got two of them just because, again, it was on sale, and I'm keeping my fingers crossed. But you get two burgers in each thing, so I'll have Nate try one too. They are vegan friendly. You get 28 grams of protein in these, which is awesome. Kind of like the Beyond Meat one too. 11 grams of fat. And 7 carbs, pretty low carb. And I really want to try it. 240 calories, yeah, that's pretty much like the other ones too. But let me know, do you like these? They look good. They do. We'll see. And they also had their Silk non-dairy yogurts on sale too. So I just got these for Nate. And I got the strawberry, this tropical pineapple one, which I don't recall like getting for him before. Blueberry and peach mango. He really likes these. I've never been really a yogurt person, but he really does like them as a treat. I did go ahead and get these Light Life Smart Dogs too, these veggie hot dogs for my kiddo. He likes these a lot, so they were on sale too, so I got those for him. And then here is the soy milk that we've been buying. So midweek last week, we ran out of the one we got from Trader Joe's. Nate ran by Vaughn's, and this is what they had. And it's unsweetened, just regular soy milk. It's not even the vanilla one, which I normally would go to, and we love it. It is good. So they had that there this time too, and I got two of those, and I'm really enjoying this now. So it's a little bit cheaper, like I said, than the flax milk with added protein. So it's been like a good alternative for us. So that is everything, guys. I hope you enjoyed this haul. Please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys very, very soon.